Hello guys, and welcome to another very quick video of the Waterbyte channel. It's going to be about the Auris Equus Date, which I've bought recently, and I must tell you, I'm going to sell this watch. If you're considering to buy an Auris Equus, you usually go and look it up on the internet and you see a lot of videos where this watch is highly recommended. And I think personally, it's an overhyped watch. The design is very nice. I think with the integrated bracelet or strap, it has a unique appearance, even though it's pretty large. It wears a little bit smaller because of this very small lug width, but I wasn't impressed by the quality. I mean, what I figured out is that the alignment wasn't really there. It's just a little bit off. Just let me show you it. It's not very big, and I know also Rolex watches have sometimes this issue, but look at it. It's a little bit off to the left. It's very small, but I haven't experienced that with Steinhardt watches, with my Forces watches. And for this, which retails for, I think, 1800 euros, I got this for 1200. I expect better quality control. And also the bezel action. Right now, it turns. And the click is okay, but this is just the effect you always have if you want to demonstrate something. Sometimes it sucks, and it's really, really difficult to turn then. It's just, this is the effect for the internet. I'm really not lying, but from time to time, it really is very difficult to do this. And this really overall doesn't give me a feeling of great quality. I mean, it's good quality, no question about that. But if I compare this to the Seiko, of course, it has its flaws, but I can get these for around 400 euros. They deliver, they have a back play, no question about that, but somehow I'm able to center the bezel. So in the end, I wasn't really impressed by the watch, and this is why I'm going to sell it. Yes, I'm a flipper and I'm losing some money, I'm sure about that. And also the crown, look at that. If it's unscrewed, this amount of back play, I mean, I don't have this amount of back play on my Seiko watches. Yeah, and also the feeling if you wind it, it's not that good. So in the end, it's not a keeper for me. It's a nicely designed watch. Many people like it, but I just wanted to share your thoughts with you before you buy it. Maybe it's a help for you. So thanks for watching. See you next time.